So I'm here at Barefoot Books in Concord, Mass, and if you have kids and haven't been here before, you definitely need to make the drive. It is a fantastic bookstore filled with the latest kids' books and unique ones and the tried and true ones, and a cute little selection of gifts as well. But they also have an amazing array of kids' activities every week. So let's go on a tour and learn about this gem west of Boston. In my little tour, I came across Ellie, the store manager, and she's going to share with us some of the fun things going on here at Barefoot Books. So Ellie, thanks for giving me the 101 about what you have here, which is just absolutely amazing. But first and foremost, you're a bookstore. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, well, we're actually, Barefoot Books is an independent book publisher. So we have all children's books, and we also have other things like cards and puzzles all around our content. And we really try to focus on international and multicultural stories and really anything that sparks children's curiosity. And we really like children to get into a story.
Yeah, absolutely. And when they're here, I mean, the colors that you have here, the designs, it's really here to inspire kids' imagination as well.
Exactly, and to bring the stories to life, and we do that through our activities that we have here.
You can talk a little bit more about those?
Yeah, so we have every week, we have story time every day, we have arts and crafts several times a week, and our story times and arts and crafts are all free and just drop in, anybody can come in. They're all different ages. We have an infant story time, so if you have a baby and you want to come in, but all our other story times are for any age, and you can just come in
And enjoy,
exactly.
That's the best part. But you also have some activities even for adults.
We do. We do Mom's Night Out, we do parent workshops, we do fundraisers for local preschools and other organizations. So we really have this great space back here that we can move tables around and make it into an adult space in the evenings.
Oh, that's fantastic. And you also have a new venture here with pottery?
Yep, we're opening a pottery studio, and so that's also something that adults can enjoy as well. We're going to have a mom's night out with a local family network, and they're going to do pottery. So you can come and paint your pieces, and you pay by piece, and then we have the kiln actually here on site, and she'll fire your pieces, and it's the woman who runs it, Elizabeth, is highly trained, and she'll help you paint, and it's a really exciting thing for us. We're really excited about it.
Yeah, I look forward to hearing more about it. Now, if people want to sort of see about the special events that you're going to have, about the Moms Nights Out, even the weekly kids activities, where do they go to get all the information and registration?
Well, if you go to barefootbooks.com, on the front you'll see a place where you can click on Visit Our Stores, and right there there'll come up a link for the Concord calendar. And a lot of our events are free and drop-in. Some things we have, like our yoga classes and Spanish classes and our kids' garden class, those you sign up for, and you'll see a link to how to connect to us and sign up for those classes there.
Excellent. So it sounds like there's a lot of stuff going on here, so maybe I can peek around and see what's going on today.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much. So I'm here at the pottery studio, which we just mentioned was a brand new venture here at Barefoot Books, and I'm with Elizabeth, the pottery studio manager, and she's going to walk us through this exciting project back here. This is fantastic.
It is. It's very exciting.
So tell me a little bit about, how somebody who's interested in coming in and painting some pottery, what do they do?
Okay, so basically what they would do is come in, and we have a lot of preformed and fired bisque shapes, the clay shapes, and they would pick out a project and pick out paint colors. And the paints they're great because they're all non-toxic, they're easy to clean up, which is very important,
very important
with
for
young
moms,
kids,
yeah,
right, exactly. And so they choose their colors and paint their piece, and as they're painting, what I try to do is not so much tell them how to paint, mm-hmm. but kind of try mm-hmm. to find out how they want to paint their piece and kind of maybe help guide them to how the product works, and so that they can really bring out their own creativity. And then they leave the piece with me. I let it dry. I glaze it with a clear glaze mm. and fire it in my kiln.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah. So then when the finished piece is ready, it's food safe, it's dishwasher safe. You can put in the microwave, oven warming.
Oh, that's right. So this is a functional piece.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's huge. That's huge.
So then you have your child's artwork, but it's on a functional piece. So
yeah, that's really nice. So you can put out some appetizers, and the grandparents might really grandparents
love it. Yep.
Grandchild made that. Yeah, exactly. And you have, I see, tons of pieces here, but some of them actually are being selected based on some of the Barefoot books.
Right. That's true. We have a lot of pieces that are, they're either tied in with specific Barefoot books titles, or they just really encompass the spirit of Barefoot books.
Yeah, so it can really bring some of those stories to life.
So kids
feel like they have another dimension to the story by even painting. That's great. But even some of the other things, I mean, don't have a Barefoot book yet, that's specific here, and I can see there's just basic plates and some boxes, so people can, obviously pick out different things that they want.
Right, exactly. It could be, so the piece itself could be a very plain, functional piece, but maybe the child was inspired through story time, and can express the story onto a blank canvas.
Mm-hmm. Or even just, we have some little bunnies here, and if it's like Easter, maybe they want to do something for, a specific holiday or time of year. But you also maybe could have parents who have a newborn, or even not so newborn, but to maybe come in and do handprints, Mother's Day, Father's Day, Teacher
Huge.
Appreciation, Grandparents Day, I think in June. Coming up, so people can do that too, right?
Right. And that is very popular. So you can do handprints, footprints. My first birthday plate. We have some keepsake plates that have holes at the top so you can hang them, and they actually have little feet around the rim, and the mugs have the handprints on them.
Oh, that's a great idea. Yeah. Oh, really nice. Is there anything else? People can come in. You have colors that people can be able to figure out what they want, but basically anything goes, right?
54 colors and 54, all different colors and shades and plenty to choose from.
Now with the kiln process, if someone was looking to do a piece for a gift, how much lead time should they have?
It's generally about a week. Around Mother's Day, Father's Day, May, June, teachers' gifts, it can get busy. So, as much time ahead for planning is better. A couple weeks would be ideal.
No, that's not too bad.
Yeah.
Especially for last minute people like myself.
Right. Exactly.
Not a 2 month process.
Right. Exactly. Right.
Okay. That's great.
So it really simplifies. Something that could be more complicated. It simplifies it down, and then you have a very functional piece in the
end. Well, Alyssa, thank you so much for walking through this great brand new space.
You're welcome.
Yeah, and definitely come out and check it out. It's really, really fantastic.